Hello. In this video, we'll be showing you how to do no-code distillation using Vertex AI. This process is based on an exciting paper from Google and academic researchers around building task-specific models. They call this process distilling step-by-step, and it uses a larger model to train a smaller, task-specific model. What's nice about this is not only do you achieve great performance with your distilled model on your specific task, but it also results in a much smaller model, which means lower inference costs as you use that model in production. We're in a new project here, and we're going to switch over to Vertex AI and enable all the recommended APIs. Before proceeding, we'll need to do a little bit of prerequisites and training data work, but just to give you an idea of what we'll be doing, let's go into the Distill page in the Vertex AI Studio. Here's where we'll be creating a distilled model. We just need example data that shows ideal input and output pairs for use in training our distilled model. At the moment of this writing, only the unicorn model can be used as a teacher model, and only the bison model can be used as the student model for your distillation work. These are both Palm 2 models. Now again, we'll need some cloud storage for use as a training job output directory, as well as for storing our training data. So let's do that before we actually run our distillation job. We can go to cloud storage directly from the card on the homepage and then create a bucket here. All the defaults should be fine. Next, we need to load some data into this bucket, and we're going to use the Cloud Shell here to show you some example data. So, how are we going to prepare the data? We simply need pairs of input and output examples in a line delimited JSON file. For our use case, wouldn't it be cool to have a personal AI stylist for our emails? The input text would simply instruct our AI model to tweak a boring professional email. And then we add our personally styled email as the output text here. We'll actually need a bare minimum of 10 examples, but the shortfall will make for a good debugging demonstration, so we'll leave it for now. We can use gsutil to copy examples to the bucket that we've created. If we refresh now, we should spot the example data. Now let's head back to Vertex AI and kick off a distillation job. Let's name our model and use our new bucket for any outputs. There are also some advanced options that we need to dive into. Our job makes use of hardware accelerators, which means some meaningful costs, a topic that we'll revisit later in the video. If you feel that the job is taking too long and burning too much cash, you can pull the plug, but then the costs were for nothing since you don't have the final model output. However, we can reduce costs and still get an output by changing the configuration to do just one training step. For production applications and a robust distilled model, classification should use at least 100 examples and 200 to 1,000 training steps. Summarization should use at least 100 to 500 examples and 1,000 to 1,500 training steps. And extractive Q&A should use at least 100 examples and 200 to 800 training steps. These recommendations are straight from the Google Cloud distillation documentation. If you, for some strange reason, care about how much you're charged for the model distillation, then watch this video in full and build out a cost model before you run anything. Two choices await when it comes to hardware accelerators. The Netherlands offers TPUs, or there's Iowa with GPUs. Let's let the TPU V3 course take the wheel. We'll leave the default service account, and a tensor board isn't necessary here. Now we'll use an existing file from cloud storage for our data, settling on the file that we uploaded a while ago. The job starts with a single click. Let the distillation begin. For a detailed view of the process, click into the pipeline run. There, you see Google's detailed process for creation of the distilled model. We can also use this to track our model's progress in real time. The interface primarily supports stopping and deleting the job. No other intervention is supported or needed. Now you may encounter errors, but don't panic. You can quickly investigate the graph and the logs to understand the issue. As mentioned before, we've got less than 10 entries in our example data. We'll bump up the example count and resubmit the job exactly as before. A quick tip is to use different file names rather than replacing the original data file, since the Vertex AI pipeline may incorrectly use subtext caching if you submit the pipeline with the same data file name and configuration. This no-code job is taking care of the hard work of data processing, training, and finally endpoint deployment. The most important part of this adventure? Training, specifically the tuning phase. Why so important? Because it's firing up 64 cores of TPU V3. That's heavy machinery at work. Further, we're using these accelerators for a non-negligible amount of time, about 30 minutes. So for this TPU usage, we're harnessing the power of 32 V3 chips, which equates to 64 cores. Even if we're only running this for an hour per month, that's $64. And remember, more training steps or training examples means a longer runtime. You'll quickly get into the hundreds or thousands of dollars for real production use cases. The other costs involved here will typically be negligible. For example, Vertex AI training, which underpins the actual running of our pipeline, remains quite affordable at around 67 cents for every 4 runs. Let's remind ourselves of the architecture here in a more intuitive way. So we've married our Vertex AI pipelines with cloud TPUs. However, we also have auxiliary services like cloud storage employed for the pipeline specification and output storage. Fortunately, these non-AI services will also be negligible in comparison to the accelerator spend. Now let's flip to the exciting part using our model in the Vertex AI Studio. From the homepage, you can locate the model in the model registry. Here's where you can deploy, test, evaluate, and version the model to your liking. And the cherry on top? You can use it seamlessly via API or SDK with the same approach as all the other LLMs in Google Cloud. For quick, hands-on experimentation, though, unleashing its power in the Vertex AI Studio is where the real thrill lies. Let's roll up our sleeves and use this model on an editing task, essentially applying our style to an otherwise quite formal email. You'll see that it spruces up the email, making it lively and informal, following in the footsteps of our distillation examples. Please leave any questions in the comments section. Thanks for watching, and please enjoy responsibly.